Hello and welcome to Smart IQ online classes. This is Venkatesh.b, Patil. Today I'm going to initiate the new initiative called Daily Challenge Strategy. The Daily Challenge Strategy 5-2-2019. It's very useful for both UPSC and KPSC aspirants for daily 5 questions and their explanations. Okay, let's begin. So first question will be there. The first daily strategy question is, the instrument of the instrument of instructions contained in the Government of India Act of 1935 has been incorporated in the Constitution of India in the year 1950. Okay, option A, the Fundamental Rights Directive Principle of State Policy, Extent of Executive Power of State, and option D is Conduct of Business of the Government of India. Okay, the question will be given, the instrument of instructions contained in the Government of India Act of 1935. It is related to the incorporated in the fundamental, option A, Fundamental Rights, option B, Directive Principle of State Policy, option C, Extent of Executive Power of State, option D, Conduct of Business of the Government of India. Okay, here answer is the Directive Principle of State Policy. Okay, the Directive Principle of State Policy talks about that is instrument, these are the instrument of instruction to the Government of India or the state government. Okay, so look at the explanation of this question. The Directive Principle of State Policy is like a instrument of instructions which were issued to the governor in general and governs of colonies and to those of India by the British government under the Government of India Act of 1935. Under the draft of the Constitution, it was proposed to issue such instructions to the presidents and governors. The text of these instruments of the instructions is found in the Schedule 4 of the Indian Constitution. Okay, so this is here, the DPSP topic is there. That is, it is mentioned in the fourth schedule of the Indian Constitution, sorry, fourth part of the Indian Constitution, Article 36 to 51. Okay, that is a directive principle. There are three kinds of directive principle of state policy. That is the liberal, intellectual principles, Gandhian principles, and socialistic principles. Okay, these principles are divided into, there are three kinds: liberal, intellectual principles, Gandhian principles, and socialistic principles. But these are the injusticiable, non-justiciable in nature. But it is only instruction of the instrument of the instruction to the Government of India and the state government. That is called the DPSP. Okay, here option A, answer is the B. That is directive principle of state policy is incorporated in the instrument of the instructions. Okay. So next question is, the members of the Constituent Assembly which drafted the Constitution of India were, okay, once again, the members of the Constituent Assembly which drafted the Constitution of India were, option A, nominated by the British Parliament, option B, nominated by the Governor General, option C, elected by the Legislative Assemblies of various provinces, option D, elected by the Indian National Congress and Muslim League. Okay, so here question is related to the Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly, members of the Constituent Assembly is taken from the which of the provinces are the British Parliament or Governor General or assemblies of various provinces or the ANC and Muslim League. So here answer is the C. Okay, elected by the Legislative Assemblies of various provinces. Okay, Constituent Assembly elected by the Legislative Assemblies of the various provinces. So look at this explanation of this question. The members of the Constituent Assembly were elected by Legislative Assemblies of various provinces. Okay, on the basis of proportional representation. Okay, this is already discussed in the topic of election in detail one, that is proportional representation as well as proportional representation is one of the system of the election system that is called proportional representation. That is proportional representation. They were nominated neither British Parliament nor by the Governor General. Once again, they are nominated. They are not nominated by the British Parliament or Governor General. Is elected through the various provinces. They represent all the parties. Okay, not only IMC, it includes all parties like all IC, ST, Muslim, separated there. That is elected from the, or represent, they are represented from all parties. So this is the answer for the members of the constituent assembly that is elected by the legislative assemblies of various provinces. So next question is Indian parliamentary system is different from the parliamentary system, the British parliamentary system, in that India has option A, both real and nominal executive, option B, the system of collective responsibility, option C, bicameral legislature, option D, the system of judicial review. Once again, I will read the question. The Indian parliamentary system is different from the British parliamentary system in that India has a both real and nominal executive, a system of collective responsibilities, bicameral legislature, the system of judicial reviews. Okay, I'll look at the answer explanation. So here answer is a D. The Indian parliamentary system is different from the British parliament, that is because of the system of judicial review. Look at the explanation. India has the judicial review, but in UK is the UK has the parliament as supreme. In the British constitution, in Britain, there is in UK, the parliament is the supreme is there, but in Indian constitution, parliament is supreme as well as the judiciary also there in the practice. There is no provision for the judicial review in the UK or Britain constitution. That's the reason it is different. Okay, India also adopted British pattern of parliamentary system. Some exception that is called the system of judicial review. In British constitution and Britain, the parliament is a supreme power is there. But in India, parliament as well as supreme court is also there. The very strong entity is there. That's the reason it is different from the Indian parliamentary system from the British parliamentary system. That is called the system of judicial review. Okay, in Britain constitution or Britain, there is no judicial review in the parliament making laws. Okay, that's the reason. Answer is D, the system of judicial review. So fourth question is, in the constitution of India, promotion of international peace and security is included in the preamble of the constitution. Option A, option B, directive principle of state policy, option C, the fundamental duties, option D, ninth schedule. Once again, I will read the question. In the constitution of India, promotion of internal peace and security is included in the option A, preamble of the constitution, option B, directive principle of state policy, option C, fundamental duties, option D, ninth schedule. So here answer is the B, that is DPSP, directive principle of state policies. It is to include in the promotion of the international peace and security of the nation. Okay, that is DPSP. So it is mentioned in the part 4th of the Indian constitution, article 36 to 51. Okay, so look at the explanation of this question. Article 51 talks about to promote international peace and security and maintain just and honorable relationship between the nations, like relation between India and Pakistan, India and Nepal, India and Bhutan, India and Bangladesh, India and China, that is the international peace and security between the two countries. To foster the respect for international law, for example, anybody can unclose, okay? United Nations Convention on Law on Sea, it is related to the sea and oceans. Okay, these international law should be respected by that countries. The international law and treaty obligations. Okay, for example, Indus Water Treaty. Okay, this is one of the treaty. It is in 1960. It's between the India and Pakistan. Okay, this is one of the treaty. You have to respect the international treaties, obligation, and encourage settlements of international dispute by arbitration. Okay, so that's the reason in the Constitution of India, promotion of international peace and security included in the directive principle of state policy, especially Article 51 talks about the international peace and security of the country. So last and fifth question is, The purpose of the inclusion of directive principle of state policy in the Indian constitution is to establish, once again, the purpose of the inclusion of directive principle of state policy in the Indian constitution is to establish, option A, political democracy, option B, social democracy, option C, Gandhian democracy, option D, social and economic democracy. Okay, here answer is the D. That is social and economic democracy, means the directive principle of state policy to promote or to inclusion of the, that is social and economic democracy of the country, okay, or the citizen of the citizens. So look at the explanations for this question. The fundamental rights aims at, the fundamental rights are mentioned in the part 3rd of the Indian Constitution, article 12 to 35. Okay, fundamental rights are the mentioned in part 3rd of the Indian Constitution, article 12 to 35. It aims at establishing the political democracy, very important, both is very important for PT. Okay, the fundamental rights aims at establishing the political democracy, whereas the directive principle of state policy aims at social and economic democracy. So very important. Okay, the fundamental rights promotes or establishing the political democracy, as well as the directive principle of state policy to promote or aims at social and economic democracy of the country. It contains the principle adherent to social and Gandhian visions, as well as economic sense. That's the reason why before I'll say that the directive principles of state policy are so divided into in three kinds of the Indian Constitution. That is socialistic principles, Gandhian principles, and third one is intellectual liberal principles. Okay, the political democracy is said that is a fundamental rights. Social democracy is also there in the directive principle of state policy, not only social democracy as well as economic democracy as well as Gandhian democracy also. That's the reason answer D is the correct answer. So this is about the, this is overall the Delhi challenge strategy. So please utilize this one and okay, thank you once again, all the best.